Myself, SM Math, Assistant Professor from Walchand Institute of Technology, Solapur. Today I am going to engage the sectional view of orthopic projections. So, regularly in the previous video, you have to know that orthopic projection, that is front view, top view, and side view. So, today I am going to explain one step ahead, that is sectional view of these orthopic projections. The learning outcome of this video is students will able to draw the orthopic projections of sectional view of the simple objects. This is a simple object, three-dimensional view placed in front of you, and we have to draw the sectional front view. Only one view is to be there. Detail, we have to study all this, how to draw the sectional view and all these things. So first of all, you have to calculate the maximum dimensions. What is the length and what is the height? And you have to, in that length and height, you make a square block for that. And in that block, you have to place this object. So when you have to calculate the distances from this end, it is a 12 mm. This ends to the center line 95. 12 plus 95, that is 107 up to the center. And the radius for this one is R25. So 107 plus 25, that is 132. So draw a length of this one, that is a 132. And the height for this one, that is, it is, this gap is 15 mm. 15 plus the center line is 60, that is 75 mm. 75 15 plus say, center line 60, 75, 75 plus 25, that is 100 mm. So height is 60 plus 15, 75, 75 plus 25, 100 mm. So make a square block of this one, 132 by 100 mm. Okay, now we have to start with the front view, sectional front view in the direction of x. So in this direction, you have to draw the sectional front view, and the section line is to be given here. That is given as a section AA. It is moving in this direction. This is a section line, hatching line. So when this portion is to be removed, that whatever the remaining portion is to be there, this portion you have to remove it. Whatever the remaining portion, you have to draw the section line. In the previous video, we have to taking the section of a object along with that rib. Rib is not a part of that object. So here, rib is not there. So whatever the complete object, you have to cut it. The other portion, which is hidden portion, is there, which is in kept in front of you. So when you have to draw the sectional front view, first you have to draw the front view. What is the front view? This portion you have to remove it, this portion. So when you have to remove this portion, is to be there. The backside portion come to the front end, and that you have to show it. So start with this point. This gap is given, it is a 12 mm. It is given here. This distance and this distance is 12 mm. From this end you have to draw, travel horizontally to the 12 mm. Then vertically gap is to be given, that is a 15 mm gap is to be there. 10 plus 5, 15 mm, and it ends up to here. Okay, then here is this part is to be removed, and this part come in front of you. That is a semicircular part. For that portion, you have to fix the center line for that. What is the radius for that? Radius is given as a R25, radius is 25 from that. So from this end, you have to travel 25 horizontally, and you have to travel downward 25 to fix the center line for that. Is a 25, and downward you have to travel 25. So this is the center for that. So So this semicircle you have to see as it is. It is because it is this shape is parallel to you, parallel to that object. Okay, this semicircular is to be there, up to here, and one more hole is to be there at the center. This hole, and the hole diameter is given as a 525, and it is parallel to you. The shape is as it is. 10. 525 means radius is 12.5 mm. Circle is to be there. Now, this slant edge, it ends somewhere here, and the end from this end, it is a 45 mm, and the vertical height for this one, it is given as a 30 mm. It is given. So travel 30 mm vertically. And horizontally, you have to travel 45 mm. Ten, 20, 30, 40, 45, up to here. And this slant edge is to be here, it is inclined for that. This inclined portion is to be there. So this portion you have to see as it is. Okay? This portion which came in front of you. So when you have to see in this object, there are two holes are there. It is given there, two holes of 515, and they are invisible one. One more thing is there, when you have to see in this object, this edge is invisible. But that when you have to cut that portion, this portion comes to in front of you. So it is seen as an edge one. So this portion, when you have to cut that portion, this semicircular part, when you have to see regular front view, these lines as a hidden one, you have to show by a dotted line. But when that you have to cut that object, a sectional line is passing through that circle, that what do you call that portion come to in front of you, and you have to get as a circular portion seen as a rectangle. So first you have to fix the center of both one. The center is to be given, it is to be given that 30 mm from this end. So first fix the center line of this one, that is a 30 mm. And another center line which is given as 50 mm from the center line. So when you have to take a cut the portion, this surface come in front of you, which is already, when you have to go for the front view, it is a hidden one. When you have to take a section for that, it comes to the surfaces. So you take as an edge, as a line, at a surface. And how much that edge line is there? It is got two holes of 515, means right and left. Radius is equal to 7.5 mm. So fix the position of the surfaces. And go for a right one, left 5 plus 7.5. 5 plus it is 7.5. 5, 6, 7, 7.5. 5, 6, 7, 7.5. So this line seen as a dark one, continuous one, because it is a surface, because you have to cut that portion. This portion, that front portion is to be removed. Okay. So when you have to take a section for that, that surface come to you, and only the hatched portion is to be given here. That is a cut portion is to be there. So this hatched portion means this is a cut portion is to be there. Section you have to taken for that, and that for surface is come to in front of you after the section line. So why do you have to go for a section of this line? Some surfaces, some lines, some edges, they are hidden one, they are come to in front of you. So pause the video, think over that. What is the edge for this one? How to see it when this portion is to be removed? So think over that. So when you have to remove this portion, this surface come to you and you seen as a line one. Okay, so this is a section of a given surface, that is a section of a given surfaces, and this portion, it is a tangent one. Actually, it is to here. When we have to draw the tangent line, you have to remove this line, and you have to draw up to that tangent line. This portion is to be there. Then you have to given the edges or the dash distances, that is, it is a 30 mm. Then this center to center line, this distance is given as 50 and this is 30 mm. It is given, that is a 30, it is 50, and this center to center line, it is given as 60, and this portion is 15 mm, and the radius for this one, it is R25 and given, and it is a R12.5. So this is all about the section of this. So for this video, I am taking the references from Engineering Graphics 1 by Professor M. L. Dabade, Vision Publications.